Hello guys, and welcome to Python Programming Tutorials by Amul's Academy. So today in this tutorial we are discussing about a pattern program. So we are printing numbers in the right triangle shape. So this is the pattern, and this pattern looks similar to the previous pattern which we discussed in the previous tutorial. This is the pattern which we discussed in the previous tutorial, and today we are discussing this pattern, and both these patterns are different. Okay, here we are printing numbers like this, in this way. So as I said, in the number pattern we can do many combinations. This is one of them. So to print this pattern, first we'll see the basic program. Okay, what is basic program? Here we want to write numbers in the right triangle shape, right? So for that, first I'll write the code. Next we'll see how to print these numbers. So in the Python file, first we'll ask the user to enter the number of rows. Okay, we'll take the input from the user. For that I'll use input function. Next, we know this input function by default take input as string, but here we want integer input. Number of rows are integer value, right? So that's why here I use int function, and here I took the variable name as n, which will store the user entered input. Next, here we can see two for loop. We are using nested for loops. And this first for loop is for row, and the next for loop is for column. In the first for loop, we took the range as n. So here I need to mention how many rows I want. I want n rows, right? We ask the user to enter the number of rows, and that value is stored in n, and we want that number of rows. So n rows. And here in column, here we can see at 0th row, we want one column. At first row, we want two columns. At second row, we want three column. Okay, so that's why here I took I plus one. Here I is nothing but row. When row is equal to zero, I want one column. That's why when I equal to zero, we'll get one column. So that's why I plus one. Next, here we can see print. It will print the value. Here we can say I left it empty because now we don't know what we want to print, right? That's why. And here we can say end is equal to space. So here while printing 3, 8, 10, after printing 3, to print 8 in the same line, I want control to be in the same line. Okay, that's why I took end is equal to space. And here after 3, a space will be printed. Next, we'll print value 8. So next, here we can see print function. This is for new line. After each row, we want new line, right? That's why this print function. Okay, so this is the basic structure to print star or number in the right triangle shape, right? So now we want to print the values. So we'll see how to print that values. In the previous pattern, in this pattern, what we did is we found out the difference between the column 0 and column 1 first. Here 6 minus 2, that is 4, 7 minus 3, 4, 8 minus 4, 4, 9 minus 4, 4. And here we got the difference as 3, here 2, here 1. Okay, so we found out the common difference, and we wrote a formula for this, and we got this pattern. So I will try same idea here. I'll find out the difference between the column, and I'll check whether we'll get the common difference or not. First, 9 minus 2, that is 7. 8 minus 3, okay, 5. 7 minus 4, that is 3. 6 minus 5, 1. Okay, so no, we are not getting the common difference. So we can't use the previous idea. We need to think something else. So to print this pattern, what I will do is I will take the last value of previous column. So for example, so this is column 0, column 1, column 2, column 3, and column 4. So to print this column 1, I will take the last value of column 0. To print column 2, I will check the last value of column 1. To print column 3, I will check the last value of column 2. To print column 4, I will check the last value of column 3. But here we can see column 0, we don't have any previous column. So that's why first, basically, I'll take a variable called x, which will hold the last column value, okay, and initialize with 0. So for column 0, the last column value will be 0. Okay, because there is no previous column for column 0, so that's why I'll take it as 0. Now here we can see I need to print 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I can write it as 0 plus 1, 0 plus 2, 0 plus 3, 0 plus 4, and 0 plus 5, right? I can print these values using this value. So for column 1, I'll take the previous column's last value. So for column 1, previous column is column 0 and the last value is 5. So here I'll take this as the last column value. Using this, we can print the column 1 value. That is 5 plus 4, 9, 5 plus 3, 8, 5 plus 2 and 5 plus 1. Okay, I can print like this. Now for column 2, I need to find out the last value of column 1, that is previous column. Now the last value is 9. So now you may ask, how 9? It should be 6, right? Then I'll tell you. So while writing this pattern manually, how will you write first 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? Next you will write 6, right? 7, 8, 9. So the last value of this column is 9. Okay. So for column 2, we can get the value from this 9 plus 1, 9 plus 2, 9 plus 3. Okay. In this way, we can get these values. Next for column 3, the last value of column 2 is 12. Okay. Because we write 10, 11, 12. Okay. That's why. Next for column 4, the last value is 14. For the next column, if any present, then this will be the last column value. If you still have confusion how to take this, I'll tell you. So while manually writing this pattern, we'll write like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, right? That's why this is the last value. This is the last value. Okay. So now we got the last value and we can find out the next column value using that value. But how to find out this last values in our program? So we took a variable called x equal to 0. Okay, so we have 0 now. To print column 0 value, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we have this previous column value, that is x equal to 0. But we want 5 now. 9, 12, 14, 15, right? 5, 9, 12, 14 and 15. So how to get this? So here we can see, what is 5? 5 is nothing but the n value, right? If I enter the number of rows as 5, then we'll get this output. If I take number of rows as 6, then here there will be another row. It will contain 6 and the last value for column 1 will be 6. Okay, so here 5 is nothing but n value, number of rows. In the program, we took variable as n, right? So it is n value. So now I need to find out x. Okay, x is nothing but the last column value. Initially, we took it as 0. Now I want it as 5. So how to write it? So can I write x is equal to n? So n value is 5. So this will satisfy, right? You will get 5. But it will remain same, right? In every situation, I'll get x as 5. But I don't want that. Here I want 9. Here I want 12. Here I want 14. Here I want 15. Okay, for different column, I want different value. So I can't use like this x equal to n. So this won't work. So next, we can write this 5 as 0 plus 5, right? This 9 as 5 plus 4. 12 as 9 plus 3. This 14 as 12 plus 2. And this 15 as 14 plus 1, right? So here, what is 0, what is 5, what is 9, what is 12, what is 14? These are all these last column values, right? That's nothing but x values. This 5, here we use that. This 9, here we use that. 12. Okay. To get the next last value, we can use the previous last value, right? So we can write formula using this, right? So here this 0, 5, 9, 12, 14 are nothing but x values. And here we can write 0 plus 5 minus 0. Then also we'll get 5, right? Instead of 4, here we can write it as 5 minus 1. Here instead of 3, I can write it as 5 minus 2. Instead of 2, I can write it as 5 minus 3. Instead of 1, I can write it as 5 minus 4. Okay. So here what is 5? That is nothing but n value. Here 5, 9, 12, 14, 15. These are the x value. Here 0, 5, 9, 12, 14. These are also x value. That is previous x value. Here 5 is nothing but number of rows, that means n value. So x is equal to x plus n, and here we want 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So for that, I'll take a variable name as k. Okay, x plus n minus k. This is the formula to find out the last column values, x plus n minus k. How it will work and why I took k, I'll explain you now. Here the formula is x equal to x plus n minus k. So now, okay, when column is 0, first column, we want x value as 0. Okay, so I don't want to execute this. I want to execute this 0 times. Right, I don't want to execute this. If I execute this, I'll get 5. I don't want this. Now, okay, I want x value should be 0. Initially, we took x as 0, right? So if I didn't execute this, x value remains 0. For column 1, okay, I want x value as 5. So to get 5 here, I need to execute 1 time. So for column 2, I want x as 9. So for that, I need to execute 2 times. Because first here we can see x is equal to x plus n minus k. Okay, here first initially k value will be 0. So x value also 0, 5 minus k, so we'll get 5. Okay, in the first time we'll get 5. Here we want 9, so for that I need to again execute this. So now 5, x value is 5, n value is 5, and k value is 1 here. So that time we'll get 9. Okay, so for column 2 we need to execute it 2 times, and here I want k as 0 and k as 1. Here I just want k as 0. Okay, so for column 3 I want x value as 12, so I need to execute it 3 times. Okay, so here we can see for different column I need to execute different times. I need to execute this formula different time. So for that, what I'll do is I'll take a for loop and I'll take range as j, because for column 0 I want to execute this formula in 0 time. For column 1, I want to execute it 1 time. For column 2, I want to execute it 2 time. For column 3, I want to execute it 3 time. Okay, this is nothing but j. Okay, so here in the column for loop, I'll take a variable called x equal to 0. Next, I'll take another for loop. And here, I'll take j. Okay, next, here I'll write x is equal to x plus n minus k. So that's nothing but when j is equal to 0, okay, in the first column, so it won't execute itself because range becomes 0 to 0. Okay, so it won't execute. So we want that, right? X remains 0. When j equal to 1, it will be 0 to 1. So it will execute only 1 time. For k equal to 0, so we'll get value 5. And for column 2, range will be from 0 to 2. So we'll get 0 and 1. So it will execute twice. For k equal to 0 and k equal to 1, so we'll get 9. Okay, so in this way it will execute. Next, we got the previous value. Now we want to print the numbers, right? But here we can see this pattern will print differently for odd column and even column. For example, for column 0, x value is 0. So we need to print 0 plus 1, 0 plus 2, 0 plus 3, 0 plus 4, 0 plus 5. But for column 1, we can see the last value is 5. We need to print like this: 5 plus 4, 5 plus 3, 5 plus 2, 5 plus 1. Okay, we need to write two different formula for odd column and even column. Okay, so first what I'll do is I'll take if condition, and if column is even, so this is the condition to check even numbers, right? So here j is nothing but column. If column is even, then I'll write a formula. If column is not even, then that means it is odd. So I'll write another formula for that. Okay. So first here, I'll take if j modulus 2 is equal to equal to 0. So first we'll write for the even columns. So for even column, we can see x value is 0. I need to print 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here I'll take I value. Okay. It is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so we need to use x value because x is the last column value. Using that, we are printing the next column value. So we need to write x plus I plus 1, because here we can see x value is 0, I value is 0, 1. So we'll get 1. So for the next value, here we can see 0, I value is 1, and plus 1, so we'll get 2. Okay, this value. Next, 0 plus 2 plus 1, so we'll get 3. Okay, so it will work for column 0. Next, I'll check whether this will work for column 2 also. So this is for column 0, it will work. So next, I'll check for column 2. So here x plus I plus 1. So here x value is 9, I value is 2 because it is in second row, and 1. So we'll get 9 plus 1, 10, 12. But here we wanted 10. Okay, so this formula worked for column 0, but it's not working for column 2. So can I include minus j also here? Here we can see, for the first condition, minus j is nothing but minus 0. So we will get the proper output. It will satisfy for column 0. Here we can see, if I do minus j value is 2 here for this. So if I apply minus 2, and we'll get 10. Okay, so it will satisfy for column 2 also. If I check for column 4, x value is 14. Okay, I value is 4. Okay, so 14 plus 4 plus 1 minus 4. Okay, so we'll get 15. Okay, so it will satisfy for each column. So this is the formula. Okay, so here what I'll do is x plus I plus 1 minus j, or I can write it as x plus I minus j plus 1. You can write in any way. So here directly I'll take print. Here I'll write x plus I minus j plus 1 and is equal to space. Okay. So next, else if the column is odd, I'll take this print only here. Okay, here if column is odd, then what I need to do now for the odd columns? Okay, so here for column 1, x is equal to 5. Okay, we need to write the formula using this. Okay, so here x plus, next I want 9 here. So to get this, what I'll do is I'll add n. So we'll get x plus n. So we'll get 10 because value is 5 and n value is 5. Okay, so we'll get 10. But here we want 9. So for that, what I'll do is I'll do minus I. Okay, because I value is 1 here. So if I do minus I, I'll get 9. So here also, for to get 8. So x plus n, we'll get 10. 10 minus 2, we'll get 8. Okay. We'll get 7, 6. This will satisfy column 1. If I go to column, so here last value is 12. So x value is 12 plus n value is 5. So we'll get 17. 17 minus I. So I is nothing but 3. Okay. So 17 minus 3, we'll get 14. Here we can see this is the value. Okay. So it will satisfy all the columns. That's why we can write it as x plus n minus I as the formula for odd columns. Okay, now if I save this and run this, we'll see what we'll get. Enter the number of rows. First I'll enter 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, we are getting the output. So next, I'll execute again. So for this, now I'll give input as 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It is printing output properly. So this is about this program. So if you know any other way to write this program, then don't forget to comment below. That's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.